And prepare for takeoff.
Doctor. 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 Dirt Style Challenge, take to the test. Bring your tapes to myself with your best acts. A mixer for a fixer, and I'm gonna create or recreate a scratch so we could catch and throw some more snares or flares or transformer, disformer or informer. So it's gonna be more informed about your scratch cat style, your prolific stylistic style, and the Dirt Style Challenge.
What up?
A dirt.
Okay, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Our first contestant of the night is a legend, and his name is Scratching. He has invented what they call a legendary scratch, what we call the Joe Fooley scratch. So here, coming live all the way, our first challenger, Joe Fooley.
What's up, my name's Joe Fooley. I'm about to bust my new scratch called the Joe Fooley scratch. Watch out, Q-Bird.
Hey, Barbie, what are you doing here?
Hey, what's up, Ken? What you doing? You still cutting? I think you need to work on your crabs. That's what's the problem and stuff. You need to get your flares going like this, you know what I'm saying? Let me watch out. Let me get over there.
Thank you.
Well, that's cool, Barb, but this is cooler. Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Oh, we're still cutting up there.
And now, from the forest and jungle of Brazil, the Tasmanian Bushman! The most scariest, turntablist in all of Brazil, the Tasmanian Bushman! The evil of all scratch monsters, the Tasmanian Bushman. He will stab you. He will eat you. He will eat your leg and hands together with rice. Kill you. Tasmanian Bushman. He will eat you. He will strangle your dog. He will make your cat swim in the water.
Kill you.
The Tasmanian Bushman from Brazil, Africa. Don't try to look for him. He will smell your dog every day.
Mentos fresh and full of life. Nothing gets to you. Stay- the Fresh Maker.
In this universe alone, there are only two warriors that can battle and destroy the evil of all planets. These are the last warriors of Planet Klon. They will destroy and kill everyone that comes into the evil person of kill everywhere. Here is the Green Hornet with his partner, Gamma Red. Master of martial arts and comes through from alien lands worldwide. They are here to destroy any actual evil, death, villainy, and arch enemy of criminals everywhere. Here is an episode where they destroy the silver statue. Episode 52, the Wax Warriors versus the Silver Statue. Get ready for action.
Come on.
take on the challenge. Anyone?
We'll do it! This sounds like a job for Bad Rabbit!
And our friend.
Let's go! For truth, justice, and the scratching one!
He was gonna beat me up if I did it. Anyway, here we go. Check it out.
2, 1.
Okay, I turned up the TV. We got a special guest in the house. DJ Total Eclipse from the Executioners, all the way from the USA. It's so Total
Eclipse. You're looking funny people.
Hey, what's so funny? You laughing at my nose? I know my nose is a big. What about you? You smell like a rat ass. Okay, anyway.
We're still. Huh? Turntable still.
The guy Scratchy Seal, he's out taking a swim in the ocean of pizza.
Okay.
Okay. So, what is up and coming of future plans for you, Total Eclipse?
For me, just to finish the album, the Executioner's album, courtesy of Loud Records.
Yeah, it's a great album. I heard it. I play it every day. It's a great album.
What do you mean? Expressions?
Yeah, Expressions. This is a great album.
Yeah, but we're working on a new album now. On Loud. Courtesy of Loud Records.
Great. Yeah. I noticed your style is very great. What is the difference of your style from everybody else in the Executioners?
More of a faster pace. Use like, you know, just do like fast patterns on like fast paced records. Pretty much.
Great, yeah, seen on your show. I'm gonna show a little clip of the show you did here in Italy. It was a great show. Everybody was going wild and throwing pizzas at everybody.
Nah, you're crazy.
Yeah, I even got hit in the face with a pizza. Okay. What are you laughing at my nose again? Damn, you need an Under Armour deodorant, even though I don't use it out here too, but you need it.
Yeah, I do.
Okay, so what is the up and coming plans for the Executioner? What are you laughing at? My damn nose.
Our upcoming plans are just to complete this album.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
That's a great album, by the way.
Take care. Well, Ruff don't know where we are. We don't know where we are. Trying to figure out what that is. Here in, we're in Florence now. Florenza.
You don't make them maybe it's an island. You don't make them scratch.
Okay, well, we are on our way to look for the Leaning Tower of Pizza, but we ended up in the wrong city. This is Florence, and, well, this is Duomo, Duomo, Church Duomo, something like that, but, yeah, we were looking for the Sistine Chapel and Michelangelo and all that stuff, and, well, we're in Florence now, this is Duomo, whatever this is, yep. Well, I want to say we made it to the Leaning Tower Pizza here in Italy. Check it out. Little Eclipse and Yoga Frog.
Tranquillo.
Yeah, I want to thank my cousin, too, that helped us find it. Thanks a lot. Okay.
Thanks a lot to Scratch Silva. Yeah, give credit all to me, because it's my dang idea to find this place. I know exactly where to go to find a damn pizza.
Ma dai, ho fatto cagare. Però io poi mi sono rifatto qua. Sì, poi ho fatto il presentatore non benissimo, però diciamo...
Let me get a picture of you.
Folks, back here, I hope you can hear me. We're dirt biking, four-wheel dirt biking right now. Here at, I don't know where we are, Puloa Ranch. We're gonna check out where Q and Spaz are. There they go, there's Spaz. There's Q. There he is. They head off this way. Pretty fun. There's Spaz. Take another lap over here. There goes Q. Go ahead. Watch him fall. Okay. I'm going to go and catch up to these guys and see you later. Bye. What's up? What's happening?
Go for a lap right now.
Go for it.
Alright, we're done.
Okay. What's up?
Thank you.
Come to Hawaii, do this right here. It's cool, man.
Yeah, you gotta do this at the Kualoa Ranch.
Yeah, give you new inspiration on scratching.
Yeah, this is inspiration of thrills. Thrill scratching. That's the next segment here, thrill scratching. So check out the thrills. Thanks a lot to everyone here. Huh? Come out, Spaz, again. Going crazy out there. Shredding.
Brown. I'm wonderful. Brown now.
Yeah, brown dirt, man. He's actually pissing in the water. He said he had to go pee. So don't swim here near Chinaman's Hat because Hubert pissed in the water. Well, back to the show. Got a backpack here. I'm wearing this because I get burnt easy, you know.
Hey, yo, come here.
And I gotta wear this rash guard. What's that? Cutmaster Spaz in the house here, in the beach actually. How's it chilling?
It's actually hot today.
Yeah, it's pretty hot.
Yeah.
Covering his head here. What? Hmm? I want to go in the water and get my camera wet. I might fall. You're going jet skiing.
It's not even a f***, it's a leaf.
Chinaman's hat.
Hey, come here, Rich.
Here we are with the first ever interview on Turntable TV with the infamous Toadman. Hi, how are you doing? Okay, my first question to you is, how did you get the name of the infamous Toadman?
One time DJ Disc and Qbert, they went over my house. One time looking into my photo album, and they seen a picture of me when I was like in the fifth grade, and they asked me, hey, can I get this picture? I said, yeah, go ahead. Then they put it on some Bravely records, and from then on, I had that name, Toadman, since 93.
Oh, interesting. So what do you think scratching will be like in 10 years?
Well, I think scratching in 10 years would be more mainstream. They'll reach like more broader audience. And I think there's going to be a lot of scratch songs, probably even closer than 10 years, to be on played on radio stations nationwide or worldwide.
Okay, and ISP credits you for their success and inspiration. What are some good advice for some upcoming scratch DJs?
Some good advice, like don't let no one knock you, just keep doing what you're gonna do, you know. First, you know, stay underground. I know it's kind of hard to be successful first, but you just keep doing it, going at it, someday you'll find your success. So just keep going.
That's some great advice.
I can't never stop working hard. Each day I feel I have to improve. Hard work, determination. I've got to keep pushing myself.
Infamous Toadman. We got DJ Flair here, interview for Turntable TV 7. And we got an email from Have One for these questions that you want to ask Flair. And so here it goes. So, how'd you create the Flair scratch?
Through a careful experimentation and a lot of practice.
Who's the first people you showed it to?
I'd have to say, have to be DJ Qbert and DJ Disc.
So, do you have any video or cassette recordings that you could show on Turntable TV?
Not at this time, but I will be coming out with a CD in the near future. Look out for it.
How's the Flair for the events? Who's responsible for that?
A lot of DJs have done a lot with it, added their own little flavor to it, so I couldn't really say.
So why do you think
has become the most overused scratch out there, up to the point where kids forget about other style of cutting.
I'd have to say, it is a good sounding scratch. It sounds good, it sounds fast. A lot of kids out there, DJs, just like it because it sounds good, and there's a lot of videos out there of DJs doing it, so kids who are coming up, they just catch on really fast, the videos, stuff like that.
Okay. So how come so many people can do it, so to speak, but before no one figures out this technique sooner?
Could you say that again? I can't really hear you.
So how many, how come so many people, figure out this technique?
Say that one more time.
How come so many people can do it, so to speak, but for no one figured out this technique sooner?
What is he saying? Let me read it. Which question is it?
Number six.
How come now so many people can do it, so to speak, but before no one figured out this technique? Oh, it's because all the videos, I believe, have helped, DJs catch on. They see the videos.
That's so fun, man.
And they I can't help it, dude. I'm busting up. All right. No, it's just that, I can't help it, dude. We gotta start all over, dude. All right. It's just the videos and stuff, a lot of kids see the videos and see DJs doing it. It's easier to catch on if you see it visually rather than, just hear it,
Yeah. Okay. So, we hired a spy to go to your house and shoot you film your routine, man. And we're gonna show it on Turntable TV. So here it goes, man.
What?
Bye.
What's up, folks? Here live at Q's house.
What's up?
Guess who we found? Here, check this guy out. The man himself.
Magic Mike.
DJ Magic Mike. DJ Disc. What's up, folks? Daly City is a very small city. I'm leaving my house. I want to show you how fast it is for me to get to Kubert's house. He's a Daly City guy now. I don't know if you guys know that. He's still the Frisco boy. And he's a Daly City kid. So what's up with everyone here? How you guys doing in Scratchland? This is Daly City. Let me give you a history about where I'm driving through. When I was in junior high, like these streets here, this would be like battle like area every Friday and Saturday after school. You know, one of these houses, you know, where it would be like someone from school and they'd hold like DJ battles inside the garages, and everyone from the whole school would come to these houses to check out a DJ battle. That's what was kind of cool. Like every week there's a DJ battle here. So DJ battles have been around for a long time here in the Bay. Well, actually Daly City, because that's the only recollection I remember of having DJ battles in the garage. I'm sure there's been more. He's getting new stuff put in the house, so hope you don't mind it. So it's like messy. Hey, look at this. See, there it is. See? Let's see. Park here. Okay. Man, this guy, this is what he does all day.
DJ Flair is on the phone. He's gonna say what's up. Ready, Flair? Go, say what's up.
What's up?
Maybe you're... This is a new Scratch Lair.
Come here, I'm gonna show everybody. Wait, I'll call you back.
Okay, let's go inside.
Okay, so you got this right here, though.
Okay, what's this gonna be?
This is gonna be the whole, my new dungeon, the new place where we scratch is called the Lair of the Octagon.
Ooh, I thought it was the Lair of Death.
No, no, okay, well, we'll change the name.
And what's this?
The Octagon, just like in was it UFC Ultimate Fighting Championship?
Yeah.
We have an Octagon. Excited.
Ooh, it's black now, I see.
Yeah,
it's in
color.
Paint
it. See, just put records in here.
Is it gonna be this wobbly?
No, 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 we're gonna nail it down. See all these things right here? Nail it down.
Okay.
Dad built this one.
Okay.
And two turntables here, mixers, two there, so that's eight turntables.
Wow, so it's like the new DJs. Place where all the great DJs are gonna practice now.
Mm-hmm.
How many turntables fit here?
Eight. You can have eight DJs on here, one turntable each.
Wow.
Four for two turntables. This is a studio.
What's this?
We put all the other equipment. It's not finished. It's gonna be a test. But here, I'll show you the.
What's this?
Layout of the studio.
Come on. Oh, is this the rug of the studio here?
Yeah, it's charcoal black. Come here, check this out. This is a drawing of the studio for a little
bit. Okay.
Okay, this is the top view of the room. This is the room right here. This is the octagon in the middle of the room. It's like an island. You can walk around here, and this is like a. Tables here for computers and shit. See, that's that right there.
I see. I thought you were having a hiding area in here.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See, this is put the equipment here. And then right here, when I was a kid, I used to like hide in like under the tables and stuff. But I told my dad to make me a little spot in here.
I could go hide in it. Just play in the phone.
All right, let's go inside here. What's happening inside? Give us a visual demonstration of the happening inside? Yeah, what's this?
We're gonna put a bathroom right in here.
Okay.
Yep.
Bathroom.
Bathroom right here. So the DJs can Okay. These are my homies that are putting the carpet together for the studio.
How's it going?
All right. And this is the studio area right here.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. And this is the back here.
This is a nice paint job.
Oh, yeah.
Yoga Frog must have painted it.
Did all by himself.
And what is this going to be?
This is just a backyard, you know, barbecue, you know, scratch and
yeah?
barbecue.
Okay.
Look at the view, check it out.
Yeah, we were looking at the view earlier.
Nice. You see the airport, see the water, it's big feng shui, feng shui.
Ah, nice water.
Yeah, get a nice big gigantic mountain right here to trip out on.
Uh-huh.
Cars. You got the freeway right there. It's really quiet out here.
Very nice. Very nice.
And,
hey, you can see the airport. Can you see some planes land?
Yeah. Watch planes land all the time. There's my neighbor right there.
Hello.
Hi.
Are you done?
Huh?
Are you done?
Yeah. What?
He said you're the ugliest neighbor I've ever had.
Devastating itch.
DJ Nando and DJ Koi.
Hi, this is Super Dave, representing the Turntable Technicians, a genius routine.
Say juggle.
This is the MIA set that I made up 2 days before the battle. Yeah.
Thank you.
scratch.
Why don't we do like them scratch pickles? They be doing that question and answer. Like, I go, and then you go, and then I'll scratch, and then after me, it'll be your turn after I go. And we'll just keep going back and forth and like communicating and shit.
All right.
Yeah, all right. So, yeah. It cut that beat in right there.
Yeah, this beat right here is pretty good. Little flavor in it.
Yeah.
Try to battle me and find self-destruction.
Oh, that's a bad
Break it.
Bitch better have my money.
With should know how to count music. Here is the count to demonstrate how to count vowels.
Hello, I am Count Scratchula. I will teach you how to count music bars. In a bar, there is four beats like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. One bar, that is one bar. One bar. Okay, now I will teach you how to count for four bars. Are you ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 beautiful bars. 4 lovely, healthy bars. 4 beautiful power bars.
Good, I'll say it good. Let's do a question and answer, but then let's like change sounds, but I ain't got no headphones.
I don't need no headphones.
I don't need no headphones either. I'm an expert.
Hell yeah.
Kick that BD right here. I need no headphones. I can find my sounds without headphones. Oh, there go right there. Alright. Go ahead.
Feel the funk, baby.
Yo, my dog.
one of their long mixes.
Albums!
Yeah.
All right, Mo Money Mo. And what's your name?
Chestnut.
We gonna come up in the game.
It's all good. It's all true love between us.
You know, recognize, count. We got a crew going on. Y'all watch out right here. Ooh, what's our crew call?
Crews in the house.
What's the crew call?
Calls the crew.
The crew.
All capital letters.
With the W in lowercase to be original. Woo! You know what I'm saying? The crew. Woo!
The crew.
Rule number two. Always use headphones. If you do not have headphones, try to stay on sound that you like. Also, if you want to search for sound, then turn your volume down just like this. Turn it down a little low, then search for sound. Not interrupting your opponent, or you will get slapped in the face.
One, two, three, four.
This takes us to lure number three. Don't talk over your opponent while he is scratching. It is very irritating to have someone scratching and someone is talking. How would you like it? Look at these idiots.
You know what I'm saying? The crew. C-R-E-W. You know what I'm saying?
You make that two W's.
I'm gonna be an MC. C-R-E-W.
And I'll do the beatbox.
Go ahead.
Let's go.
We gonna win the album. Hey, let's do another question and answer. I'll go first. Did you? Oh, it's a Toad Man. What up? Hey, blood. Hey, check us out. Scratch, dude.
I'm kicking the beat right now.
All right, kicking the beat. I'm going to do a question and answer. I'll go with you. Go ahead, kicking it.
You want to die?
Oh man, you know, what's up?
I hope this teaches you how to have respect for your partner when you are scratching, and to know when it is your turn to go. Now here is DJ Flair and DJ Cubart to teach you how to do it the correct way. Thank you.
And Smucker's Goober Grape. It's a mother smucker.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right now it's playing one of the dark style records, and that's on sale too. talking straight up. And this comes with the Vinyl Killer fan right here. And the Parabo record right here for free too. Real cool. Check this out. Oh yeah. This is really cool stuff. And this is just too cool. I don't know how much I'm gonna let this go for, but it's on sale today for $1 million. I will pay for shipping and handling. I'll box it up, I'll even put foam in there and everything and add a couple sardines. And check this out, if you press this Parappa the Rapper right here, it even scratches too. Junkies and turntable toy enthusiasts, this is the one to get right here. This is the real deal. Real deal seal on the wheels of steel. That's right. All right, check it out. Let's go to our next item. Okay, now this is for all you model freaks, turntable freaks. Check this out. This is a record player kit, and what it does is you put it together and has like a paper horn and a needle, and it has a little plastic record that comes with it, and you put it all together, and it's like the lightest turntable on earth. It only weighs like, I think like two feathers. It weighs two feathers, the lightest turntable in the world. Yeah, that's right. That's why this one's really expensive, and this one's on sale this week only for $7,000,072. But that's cents, not dollars, so it's a lot cheaper. So remember that's 7 million cents, and you get this thing, and I'll wrap it up. And I'll even put an autographed picture of me and me catching some crabs and running around town and naked. But I am naked right now. Hey, you know what? I'm naked right now. Is that a trip? I'm on TV naked right now. Yeah, that's a damn trip right there. I think animals can be naked every day. Anyway, check it out. This is on sale for 7 million cents. And it even scratches too if you shake the box. Okay, check this out. For all you jewelry enthusiasts, DJs, this watch is made by G-Shock, and it's one of a kind because they don't make it anymore. Nuh-uh. No way, siree. Check it out. This watch right here is just too cool for school. It's the G-Shock Special DJ Watch. Now, keep your eye on the G right here. Look, here you go. See it right there? Keep your eye on the G. Watch the DJ. Just one cent. Now, this stuff down here is the actual controller. This is this stuff down here is $1 billion. Right here. This right here is the control turntable, and it this makes scratch sound effects for the PlayStation. Check it out. And now this thing over here is the disc, the CD, which goes into the PlayStation right here. The Beatmania disc. And this is cheap though. This is only $100,000. The controller is $1 million, but this is $100,000. But get this, this box is 1 cent. That's right, the most cheapest thing in the store. So call the number on your screen, and we'll get busy and send this to you right away. It'll be sent to you in 1 year. That's right. So I'll see you guys later, and we'll have more toys for you next week. See you later, kids. Bye.
Thanks for watching the Turntable Toy Store with Scratchy Seal. See you next time, kids. Bye-bye.
Based on Qbert's debut solo album, Wave Twisters the Movie is a work-in-progress pioneering animation and mixed media project that was originally the brainchild of DJ Qbert along with fellow Invisible Scratch Pickles DJ Yoga Frog.
We always thought of doing something like this, or we dreamed of like, hey, well, why not a movie of just with all scratching, you know, DJs doing scratching and even like all the, if it's a superhero kind of thing, all the superheroes are doing like superhero powers, but with scratching.
Next up was Qbert's music.
One day, he had this one song. He did one song a long time ago. I forgot what it was called, but anyway, let's just say Red Worm, because Red Worm was one of the first songs. And then when Red Worm came along, it's like a story in there, you know. And all of a sudden, he was just conjuring up all these things with. The next songs he would make, and he said, hey, you know, all my songs are all space stuff, you know, why not make it like a, you know, like the Beatles' Yellow Submarine.
Of course, having a concept and executing it are two different things. Enter the creative process video computer animation experts Sid Guerin and Eric Henry, along with OG graffiti artist Doug One, who does all the basic graphics from scratch.
So it's still development of him. We're going through all these looks right here. He's just really round-headed.
Right.
Starting to get the goofy teeth thing going. And keeps changing. The body forms are changing. We decided to go a little more serious with him. And you can just kind of see, like, little by little.
Right.
He just starts developing into something a little bit more. Now we got him a little more realistic.
Uh-huh. Who's that guy there?
These are just early sketches of maybe what the octopus people would look like.
As Doug One designs and shapes all the images, he draws heavily from his graffiti background. In fact, Doug One is always thinking in terms of the four elements of hip-hop, including the analogy of the DJ.
I guess the way a DJ would work, you know, and what I'm creating here are the scratch sounds and the records themselves. And once I have this visual wax created, I hand it over to Sid and Eric, which are the DJs and producers.
Once we've decided how it makes sense, what's going on in the story, we sit down with Doug and sketch out storyboards for what happens. And it's all broken down by song. Then we take all the storyboards, scan them, cut them out, put them into a program called Adobe After Effects, where you can see it's cut out on a background.
Now I am the Red Worm.
You Using scratches and other sounds, Sid and Eric carefully visualize and interpret Q-Bert's music. For Eric, a common difficulty is describing scratch sounds.
Hey Sid, what should the sound like? You know, what should that be? And kind of having to say scratch noises is a little embarrassing.
There's no
language. It kind of sounds stupid when you're saying.
Unlike most video projects where the visual comes first, with Wave Twisters, the music is the foundation, and all else follows it. For Sid, Eric, and Doug One, making Wave Twisters is a slow and often tedious process, with a good day's production resulting in maybe just 5 seconds of completed animation. Consequently, the entire project will take about 1 year to finish, with a scheduled release date of July 2000. Still, Sid insists that it's not that difficult, especially in these easy access and affordable high-tech times.
Going to film school or having some film knowledge certainly helps putting it together, understanding when to go from wide shots to close-ups and pacing, editing, those things all help. But really, basically, a good attitude and an iMac is all you would really need.
Not only because of his talent at what he does, but the physical limitations he does it under. His name is Patrick Lewis, and he's known to his friends and fans as DJ Flex. He spins records in his hometown in Texas, and that in and of itself is not that unusual. What is how he gets the job done. You see, DJ Flex has no arms and no legs.
Your station, Nip Jones on your radio. Funky Fresh Freaking Friday night, overnight house party with my man DJ Scorpio by my side. I got my man Sergio in the house. And we got special studio guests tonight, man. We got our boy from around the way. Yes, he is DJ Flex on the wheels of steel. What up, man?
House party, house party, house party,
If you put me up against 100 DJs and make them use their elbows, then the verdict would, it wouldn't even be hands down. Ever since I was a little boy, I've been just fascinated with music. And I was raised up in West Texas, but whenever I came to Dallas and heard the local DJs on the air, it was just like, that's it. If it's dreamable, then I feel like it can be accomplished because I don't sell myself short for anything. I feel like I was born in life with a short, but I'm not accepting anymore. If I don't make it, then I'll die trying.
He hopes to one day produce his own artists so they may get a chance to express themselves like he's been given the opportunity to.